बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास। टुडे आवर टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज़ फीडिंग ग्रुप्स ऑफ फिशेस फ्रॉम द कोर्स ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ फिश बायोलॉजी। लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम इंट्रोडक्शन। स्टडिंग ऑफ फूड एंड फीडिंग हैबिट इज़ कॉल्ड ट्रॉफिक बायोलॉजी। ट्रॉफिक बायोलॉजी इन्वॉल्व प्रैक्टिकल मैनेजमेंट ऑफ फिश रिसोर्स। द स्टडी ऑफ फूड एंड फीडिंग हैबिट ऑफ फिश स्पीशीज इज अ सब्जेक्ट ऑफ कंटिन्यूस रिसर्च। The natural habitat offer a great diversity of organisms that are used as food by fish, which differ in size and taxonomic groups. The dietary analysis of fish in their natural habitat enhance the understanding of the growth, abundance, productivity, distribution of organism. Study on natural feeding of fish could provide useful information on the trophic relationship in aquatic ecosystem. By studying these topic, you can get information about feeding behavior of fish, how fish can get their food from their environment, and how this information is useful for us. Feeding habits of fishes. Fishes may be classified by their feeding habits into different groups. First one is herbivores. Herbivores fishes includes those fishes which feed on exclusively on plant materials. Second, carnivores fish feed on exclusively on animal matters. Omnivores fishes feed on both plant and animal matters. Planktivores fish feed on planktons. Larvivores fish feed on insect larvae. Voracious fish craving or consuming large quantities of food. Last one is detritivorous fishes. Fish feed on decaying plant and animal matters. These are the scenario of major feeding groups of fishes like omnivorous, herbivorous, carnivorous. Omnivorous fishes are those fishes which feed on both plant and animal materials like herbivore and carni omnivores. Example of omnivorous fishes include freshwater angelfish and different type of barbs. Herbivorous fishes are further divided into two species, planktophagous and detritophagous. What is planktophagous? Include those fishes which feed on plankton such as silver carp, Hypophthalmicthyes molitrix, consuming phytoplankton as their main food. But certain fishes basically utilize zooplankton. And the second fish species is detritophagous. Detritophagous include those fishes which subsisting mainly on detritus. That's why large quantity of sand or mud is encountered in their gut. Third feeding group is carnivorous, which is further divided into different feeding groups like insectivorous, carcinophagous, malacophagous, piscivorous, larvivorous, cannibalistic. Insectivorous fishes are those fishes which commonly feed on insect like rainbow fishes. Carcinophagous include crab eater fish species also called lobe-toothed because its lobe teeth adapted to filtering their small crustacean prey. Malacophagous fishes belong to Cichlidae family. Piscivorous fishes is defined as carnivorous fishes that consume large fish as a prey. Larvivorous fishes are those fishes that feed on insect larvae such as freshwater gambasia. Cannibalistic behavior is also observed in different fishes. Cannibalism refers to the action of attacking and consuming member of own species. These are those species which feed mainly member of their own species, like juvenile cannibalism in Asian sea bass. Based on amount of available food, fishes are further divided into different feeding groups like monophagic, euryphagic, and stenophagic. What is monophagic? Monophagic groups include those species which is basically consume only one kind of food. And euryphagic fishes is not necessarily an omnivorous or herbivorous. They may be carnivores. Uriphagic fishes feeding on wide variety of active prey. Their examples include mackerel, sardines, and fishes of myctopodid family. Like uriphagic, stenophagic fishes also feed on wide range of food materials and obtain their nourishment from plants as well as animals. Based on trophic niches, fishes have specific area for their feeding, like rahu, which is marginal feeders, and katla is surface feeders. Marigal fishes, which is also called mori, feed on bottom of the pond. They are called bottom feeders. Some fishes are mid feeders, or they are called column feeders, like osteochelys and thomases. Due to different feeding habit, most fish mouths fall into three general types: superior or supraterminal mouth, or upturns. Terminal mouth are those fishes which contains mouth which is pointed straight forward and are the most common mouth type. Inferior or subterminal mouth are those type of mouth which are turned downward. Feeding habits of fishes. Generally, fishes have different type of feeding habit. Herbivorous fishes. Herbivorous fishes are those fishes which feed only plant materials and their food consists of filamentous algae. Some examples are given below, like Labiorhita, Labiogonius, and Tenofringodon idella. All of these fishes are herbivorous fishes. What are the feeding behavior of Labiorhita? During the early stages of its life cycle, it eats mainly zooplankton, but as it grows, it eats more and more phytoplankton. What are the feeding behavior of Labiogonius? Is also known as herbivorous species. It feeds mainly on algae and higher plant materials. Tenofringodon idella feed on a wide range of aquatic vegetation and are capable of consuming 40 to 300% of their body mass per day of plant material, depending upon their age and size. Their adults are completely vegetarian. Some general characteristics of herbivorous species. Herbivorous species are those that will eat only plant materials. These fishes need to graze very often, and whether they are fed regularly or not, they will nip at your plant life. A herbivorous species diet consists of plants, algae, vegetables, and different type of fruits. Unlike a carnivorous species, they don't have a true stomach. Instead, their intestine break down the food. For this reason, they need to eat more frequently. They have flat teeth, which helps them to grind food before they swallow. Their intestine is 3 times enlarged than their body length. In herbivorous species, stomach is totally absent. That's why their intestine is modified for the digestion of their food. Their intestine is lined with finger-like outpocketing villi that increase the surface area for absorption of food. These are recommended food for different herbivorous species: cucumber, peas, and potatoes. These can be kept frozen and be chopped into tiny pieces at mealtime. Vegetable flakes come in a variety of flavors. Algal flakes will also be a favorite among these kind of fishes. Now we will discuss another kind of feeding group, that is plankton eater. Some species of fish feed entirely on zoo and phytoplankton. Young forage fish such as herring mostly feed on phytoplankton, and as they mature, they start to consume larger organism. Older herring feeds on zooplankton, tiny animals that are found in oceanic surface water, and different type of fish larvae and fries. Example include of plankton eater is katla. Katla fish are surface and midwater feeders. Their young feed on both zooplankton and phytoplankton, but mature fish are generally feed on zooplankton. Now we will discuss different type of planktons which are available as a food material to different fishes. देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ प्लांकटन, जुओ प्लांकटन एंड फाइटो प्लांकटन. जुओ प्लांकटन आर फर्दर डिवाइडेड इंटू टू टाइप्स, होलो प्लांकटन एंड मीरो प्लांकटन. वट इज होलो प्लांकटन एंड मीरो प्लांकटन? दीज आर कॉन्ट्रेरी टू ईच अदर. होलो प्लांकटन आर प्लांकटिक, दे लिव इन वाटर कॉलम एंड कैन नॉट स्विम अगेंस्ट अ वाटर करंट. वाइल मीरो प्लांकटन आर दोज प्लांकटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म हु स्पेंड पार्ट ऑफ देयर लाइफ साइकिल इन द बेंथिक जोन ऑफ एनी वाटर बॉडी. फाइटो प्लांकटन, फाइटो प्लांकटन हैव डिफरेंट टाइप्स, बेसिलरियो फाइसी, डाइनोफाइसी, साइनोफाइसी एंड क्लोरोफाइसी. वट इज बेसिलरियो फाइसी? बेसिलरियो फाइसी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड डायटॉम्स. इट इज अ यूनिसेलुलर अल्जी, मे बी कलोनियल आर फिलामेंटस. वाइल डाइनोफाइसी बिलोंग टू द क्लास डाइनोफ्लैजिलेट्स. These are also called benthic dinoflagellates found in sediments. Cyanophyceae, these are free living photosynthetic bacteria. Chlorophyceae include green algae. Ecologically, water body have different zonations and each zone have different type of planktons, like ponds have haloplanktons, lake have limnoplanktons, rheoplanktons are found in running water. And hypomeroplanktons are found in brackish water. Helioplanktons are present in marine environment. Net planktons include megaloplanktons, ranges from 20 millimeter, less than 20 millimeters. Their examples include jellyfish. Micronectons ranges from 20 to 200 millimeters, and macroplanktons ranges from 2 to 20 millimeters. Their examples include different type of copepods and mesoplanktons ranges from 200 micrometer to 2 millimeters, and their examples include different type of cladocerons. Water bottle planktons include microplanktons, nanoplankton, ultraplanktons or picoplanktons, and different type of cyanobacteria. Microplanktons ranges from 20 to 200 micrometer. Their examples include copepod, Napoli and most phytoplanktons. Nanoplanktons ranges from 2 to 20 micrometers, include fungi and small diatoms. Ultraplanktons are picoplanktons ranges from less than 2 micrometers. They include mainly different type of bacteria and cyanobacteria. All of these planktons are available as food material to different fishes in different zone of the water body. These are some natural foods of fishes, that is benthos, plankton, nekton and detritus. What is nekton? Nektons are aquatic animals that are able to swim and move independently in water current. Their examples include fishes and different types of shrimps. What is plankton? Planktons are the diverse collection of organisms that live in large body of water and unable to swim against water current. Planktons made up of tiny plants. These are further divided into different types, zooplanktons and pseudoplanktons. What is pseudoplankton? Pseudoplankton organisms are those that attach themselves to planktonic organism or other floating object like spirula, while zooplanktons are free floating organism that live in open water. So they are also called open water planktons. Zooplanktons have two types of planktons. Phytoplanktons are zooplankton. Phytoplanktons are tiny plants, while zooplanktons are tiny animals. What is benthos? Benthos are aquatic organisms that crawl in sediments at the bottom of body of water. There are different types of benthos, zoobenthos and phytobenthos. Zoobenthos are microscopic animals that live in or on near the seabeds, include insect larvae, annelids and different type of mollusks. Phytobenthos. Phytobenthos are microscopic plants that live attached to substrates such as rock, stone or larger plants. And the last one is detritus food. Detritus food are available in different area of water bodies. They may be available in पेलैजिक जोन आर मे बी अवेलेबल इन बेंथिक जोन. डेट्रिटस फूड मे बी सस्पेंडेड इन वाटर बॉडी आर मे बी सेटल्ड इन द बॉटम ऑफ पॉन्ड. Another feeding group of fishes is larvivorous. Some species specialized for only one type of food and are referred to as insectivorous, larvivorous, piscivorous. These species mostly feed on the larvae of crustaceans, mollusks, and different insects. Examples include gambasia and lake trout. Feeding behavior of gambasia and lake trout include they are typically eat zooplankton, mites and mosquito larva. Another major feeding group of fishes is carnivorous fishes. Carnivorous fishes feed on insects, fish fries, fingerlings, etc. These are also called predatory or meat eating fishes. Species belonging to this group include Vlaguato, Notopterus chaetala and Mr. Singala. These are the species which require higher level of protein in their diet than herbivores in order to survive. Some general characteristics of carnivorous fishes. Carnivorous fishes eat other fish and meat in the ocean. Rather than chewing on their meat, carnivorous fishes are able to tear part of their prey up and swallow them whole. While a carnivorous fishes might eat plants, the plants provide no nutritional value to them, just help them in their digestion. Instead, their digestive tract is developed to handle large piece of meat and have room for a whole fish in their stomach. Their stomach is muscular and elastic for holding large prey items as compared to omnivorous or planktivorous fishes. The diet of carnivorous fishes include meat of alive or dead organisms. Some recommended food for the carnivorous fishes. Carnivorous fishes food include earthworms, redworms, tubifex worms and daphnia. Larvae of mosquito are fruit flies, oysters, shrimps, clams and other fishes. Carnivores need at least 45% of protein in their food, without which they become severely malnourished. Although many of the prepared food are spiked with extra protein to help such fish, carnivores are happiest when they are fed leaf-like worms. Examples of carnivorous fish include piranhas, sea basses, and tuna fish. Whales. Killer whales are carnivorous fishes that live about 50 to 80 years. Killer whales weigh up to 6 tons. They hunt in group of up to 40 whales. Some fishes are voracious feeder. Voracious mean those fishes which crave are consuming large quantity of food. Eels are voracious carnivores and consume a variety of fishes and invertebrates such as insect, crayfish, snail and worms. Shark is an active voracious predator of invertebrates and fish. The potential of the larvivorous fish Gambasia to ingest large number of mosquito larvae lead to series of laboratory-based study. That's why larvivorous fishes like Gambasia is also called voracious feeder, and shark and eels are also voracious feeder fishes. Omnivorous fishes are also included in major feeding group of fishes. Omnivorous fishes are those fishes which consume mixed diet of both plant and animal material. Heteronustes fossilis, Clarius batrachus and Cyprinus scarpio are included in the group of omnivorous fishes. Now we will discuss feeding habits of omnivorous fishes. Feeding habit of Nile tilapia. Normally, tilapia is considered herbivores. Tilapia prefer to eat phytoplankton in natural rivers or lake. But in the lake with less phytoplankton, tilapia eats not only phytoplankton but also algae, aquatic plant, zooplankton, aquatic insect, benthos and organic matter in the middle of road. Therefore, tilapia is considered as omnivorous as well. Feeding habit of African catfish, which is also called omnivorous fishes because they also have dual feeding habit like नाइल तिलापिया। दे ईट एक्वेटिक इंसेक्ट, एम्फीबियन फ्रॉग, क्रस्टेशियंस, स्पाइरल शेल, क्रश्ड प्लांट, ऑर्गेनिक मैटर इन द मिडल ऑफ रोड एंड सो ऑन। लास्ट फीडिंग ग्रुप ऑफ फिशेज इज कॉल्ड लिमनीवोरस फिशेज। लिमनीवोरस फिशेज आर आल्सो नोन एज मड ईटर। लिमनीवोरस फिशेज फीड मेनली ऑन अल्जी एंड ऑन द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म इन योर एक्वेरियम। दिस काइंड ऑफ फिश आर कॉन्स्टेंटली ईटिंग एंड कैन बी गिवन पैलेट्स एंड अल्जी बेस फूड। देयर एग्जाम्पल्स इंक्लूड गिपी एंड डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ गोल्ड फिशेज। दीज आर सम रेफरेंसेस। Any question, please?